Whenever we want to see data in PyDataLink, so all this data here and here, it starts with knowing what data we want to look for, right? So that comes in from PySearch. Search is what allows us to find what data items we actually want to look at. So all these tags here and all these tags down here, that's all from search. So understanding how search works and what you can do with it is pretty important. To demonstrate it, we are going to go over to a clean sheet and we are just going to search a bunch of things and show you what you can do with it. So to start off with, when you click on search, you are brought into this dialog. So just go to home and you will see first off, it's divided into two types of options here. Option one are the classic PyData Archive servers. Here we see only one PyData Archive server called PyServ01, but you can of course have multiple servers here. So if you want to search by PyTag names, that's where you will want to go. That's what we will do first, and then we will come back and look at some AF attributes. As you can see, we have a bunch of filters available that can help you find the data that you need, like what point type it is, what engineering units, extended descriptor, and so on. Alternatively, if you are familiar with the PyPoints naming convention, you can also use the search box and just type in the PyPoint name directly here. You can of course use wildcards in this field here. So this is just like any classic PyTag search. Once I find the one that I need, I will say OK, and it's put onto my sheet, and I can open up a current value function. Just click on that as a data item and I get the value right there. Now, if I wanted to do the same type of search but do it for a PyAF attribute, I would simply go to search again. Select my AF server. So this is which allows you to browse your Py system based on the asset structure. So what's the form? What's the organization of your plant? And you can find your data through that. So we click on our AF server and then we can just browse in the OSIsoft plant database. So this is the asset structure. I'm just diving in and digging in, seeing what's underneath each one. And I see I have a mixing tank here. And the mixing tank has quite a few attributes right here. And if I select one and say OK, the text of that is put onto my sheet and is the whole path to the final attribute that I'm interested in seeing, the external temperature of my mixing tank one. Then what I can do with this is I can link it up to a current value and I get data out. That's pretty simple. So that's the basics of searching. It's how you could search for a Py tag or dive into your Py AF tree and just use your understanding of how your plant is organized to find the attributes that you want. Thanks for watching.